See, this is a short follow-up video to my previous video about my HP E3630A, where I modified it and tested it and all that kind of stuff. And I was a little bit sad and confused about the oscillations after a load dump. So I called one of my sponsors, and thanks a million times again, and got another one. And as you can see, this is exactly the same model, age, and everything. It even got the same modifications and all that kind of stuff. So it's exactly the same power supply. And what do you know? Look at that. It does exactly the same. So this is the load dump test at 500 milliamps. And if I go to, was it 400? See, this is a load dump from 400, so it changes. And I think it is, if I go to, let's say, 350. See? It really affects this oscillation kind of stuff. And let me go down to 300. Oh, it's almost gone. Let's try and go to 250. See? That is a normal load dump. This is what you want to see. The voltage rise, and then this regulation, and then it's stable again. This is exactly what we want to see. So, yeah, there is a design problem in this model of power supply. Just couldn't let this go. And in the manual, there is actually a troubleshooting guide about those oscillations after load drop and unstable load drops. And they talk about capacitors. The first thing they talk about is actually those tiny little capacitors here. So this is C11, C20, and C25. I really don't believe those are the ones to blame, to be honest. I find that a little bit weird. So they also talk about the output capacitors, and they talk about main rectifier capacitors. So I've been through all these, and I don't see any kind of problems. So I started to solder some capacitors like this on the back of the PCB, and just testing around if there were any difference. And then when I soldered in this area, I had this very, very funny smell of leaked capacitor, and I really couldn't see the wet PCB around here. And that capacitor, C14, that was leaked. The fun thing is that my unstable kind of problem didn't go away when I had another capacitor across that one. So anyway, I'll try and clean this up and see if that is the problem. But I just don't give up on this annoying power supply and this the oscillation problems. So I spent last night trying different capacitors add-on here. I of course changed the capacitors. I changed the capacitors in the auxiliary supply. One was leaked, no effect at all. Those are the three output capacitors. I changed those to brand new ones. And I also tried adding super low ESR capacitors in parallel. No to little effects. But today, I got the schematic. And by looking at the schematic, it was so easy to figure out exactly what was the problem. And here's the solution. This is Q5. This is the positive driver for the output transistor. And the emitter, I needed to cut that track and put in a 47 ohm. So this is a local feedback to kick down the gain at very high frequencies. And there's actually a little reveal about why it is like this in the schematic. You'll see they put on ferret beads on the emitters of Q5. And also Q7, that's the negative. The negative is not doing that. It's because those are different transistors, a little bit different gain. And I mean, that is why both my units, they do this. It's just because there's just a tiny bit more gain in Q5 than they designed this unit for. And if we look at the schematic, it's quite obvious to see the top right op amp, that is the voltage feedback mode. You can see there's CR13, and there is no serious resistor from the op amp directly to Q5 base. That is also a little bit stupid, by the way. Normally you would limit the current gain here and the control gain just a little notch. So that could be a good way to do it as well. At my first try, I also tried to remove CR11. I just disconnected one side, and that was to prove that there was no glitches coming from the current feedback op amp. And that was, of course, the case. It is all a voltage feedback problem. So then you can see from Q5 emitter going down to Q10 base, again, no resistors. There's nothing that prevents you from going absolutely berserkers and high frequency mode here. So, and if you see the feedback or the L2 ferret bead, if you cut that track and put in a 47 ohm resistor, then you limit the high frequency gain and you'll still be able to have plenty of output power and all the output current you want and all that kind of stuff. I will of course also do this with a negative supply. So that is the L3 and Q7. And that is what I'm going to experiment with now. I also tried to remove all my previous hacks and put back all the diodes and resistors and all the other funny experiments I did. So now it's only this 47 ohms in series with Q5 emitter. And if you look at that, so this is the same kind of load dump test. And now it's completely stable and all that stuff. So that is a great hack to fix this machine. Just to prove my point, I'm of course doing the same modifications to the second one. And this one got, now I actually cleaned this up, but around this big capacitor here, I had leakage. So that one, the big one here is also leaked. And that one I just removed here also leaked exactly as it did in mine. So that definitely needs to be replaced, and it's probably because that one is located very close to the heatsink of U1. So that is something to address, and you're of course also a correct reefer. They just gotta go and put in a new, and then I'll of course do the same with the two emitter resistors. So now the next one is fixed super easy and fast when you know exactly what to do. I changed those capacitors and that one, and look what happened here is the output. And this is of course my load dump test. Haha! Of course it works. Super happy. So thank you very much for watching. I hope this will be a fix that you can use as well. Just wanted to add two more schematic clips. This is actually also an HP power supply. First let's look at its 5 volt regulator section. If you look here at the schematic Q8 and Q9, you'll see the two resistors to tame the gain and make the power supply stable. Note this is a low voltage fixed output, so of course the resistor values here, they're quite low. And if we look at the plus 15 volt output on the same power supply, you'll see again near Q2 and Q3 here, also two resistors to tame and stabilizes the gain. And here the values there are of course much higher due to the higher output voltage and lower current needs. So yes, HP learned about this and fixed it in their other power supplies about same age.